All right, so ladies and gentlemen, moving on to the next part, we have this presentation prepared and the topic is going to be creating healing environment, patient-centric healthcare design and execution. For the same, I would request Mr. Rajiv Khanna, National Head, Godrej Interio, to join us on the stage for the presentation.
Good afternoon. I think it has been a very hard and a lot of thoughts had been going. So, yeah, this is working. Yeah. So, good afternoon, friends. Can I hear good afternoon? Thank you. Yeah. So, I come from Godrej. It will be a 15 minutes. And definitely, the topic today is patient-centric healing and design. So, we have actually done a lot of research to bring this presentation to you. And we will put our thoughts to you. Let me take you to a flight. What you actually see is an inside of an aircraft. We have this photograph from another angle now. Actually, this is not a flight. We have actually created an environment to look like a flight, to look like the interiors of the aeroplane. We have another picture. We were talking about the stakeholders and design. For any design to be successful, it has to relate to the stakeholders. And we at Godrej understand the importance of creating the right environment. So setting up the theme for any hospital also, it is most important that we have to create the right environment for the patient to recover fast. So the topic of today is creating healing environment, patient-centric healthcare design and execution. What is actually healing environment? So going by the Wikipedia, it is a physical setting that supports patients and families. We were talking of the families. Yes, they are the most important part of any setup. In the process of healing through efficiency, empathy, and well-being for everyone involved in the process of healing. And definitely there is a lot of research. A physical design of hospital rooms can reduce medical errors. We talked today. We talked a lot of about the medical errors, that 9% of fatality actually happens because of medical errors. Lower stress levels among staff and patients and promote faster healing. What we are actually working as Godrej, we work in two platforms. One is the human-centric products and second is the adaptive space. We do turnkey executions. We integrate lot of solution, we integrate building material and provide the solution. How it actually happens is that foster patient healing and safety, because patient is at the center where the whole focus have to be there, creating the whole environment around the patient so that the faster healing has to be obtained. And no doubt the caregiver, the satisfaction of the attendant have to be managed. And family who is always there at a panic and an anxiety state have to be attended. We at Interio, Godrej Healthcare are specialized at understanding the changing dynamics and complexity of healthcare spaces. So we create healing environment. We do the execution part. So these are the certain applications that we have been actually doing that. So you look at the typical patient registration area right now. This is something what we have actually made it colorful. Depends upon the choice of the colors. Somebody in the panel today actually spoke about the right colors, the right environment. So it is a research that we have to do. What is the type of environment we want to create? Is it to be built around anxiety, or we have to make the customers, the patients, the people coming inside to have the relaxation over there? So the patient registration is actually the blend of the products and the total environment that goes to create the whole environment. Similarly, if you talk of the patient room, the whole focus is for the faster recovery of the patient. For the OPD, what is most required? It is the rich interaction of a doctor with the patient. So where the products have to be placed, what is the angle, what is the degree of the placement, and how is the healing environment to be created? How effective interaction will be happening with the patient and the doctor? This is how we actually create and work along with the hospitals. For ICUs, we talked of the space planning. That goes with the integration of the products that goes in any of the ICUs. Similarly, for waiting areas, it has to be relaxing. and canteens. It has to be refreshing. So what is the color that we want to add? What is the type of products we want to add? What is the traffic that we are actually envisaging over there? So until and unless we don't plan everything, what is the environment we want to create, we cannot actually make the reality of healing environment happen. Godrej is in fact experts in ergonomics research, and all our products that are actually made, like what we talk of chairs or maybe the staff seating, all depends upon the ergonomics and the space solution that we want to provide. So there are a lot of solutions that we provide in-house from our manufacturing. Similarly for training room, space, design, and comfort of the students who are actually sitting over there. So this is one of the typical training room that we have actually shown over here. What we are actually showing is that the table as well as the chair is itself flexible. The table is movable, the chair is also flexible. So it creates extra space also. So wherever we have a challenge of space, we have certain designs to suit your requirements. For record rooms, there is always a challenge that the files are always growing up and we don't have that space to pile. So like any typical environment where we have the racking system and it looks very odd, we have the compactor system that gives a very efficient space saving solution. How we are actually doing it? So the philosophy actually lies in patient and caregiver experience. There are certain stated and unstated needs. So everything have to be studied, and based on that, based on research only, we are able to create an environment and the products that we actually design. Human-centric design approach, that is the ergonomics, the study that actually goes of how a patient will be behaving, how the patient actually needs the care, what are the type of environment that we need to create. So everything actually revolves around healing of the patient and faster recovery of the patient. Similarly, we talked of a lot of projects. Cost management is the game, actually. If we are not able to adhere on the material, we are not having the knowledge of the right type of products, right type of material that will be going, so everything will go haywire. Similarly, if the project is not completed on time, the cost actually shoots up. This is most essential, that timely management of the cost, timely management of the projects have to be done. Now, while we were talking of ergonomics, just an example how a human-centric approach is actually done. We have a typical example of an examination couch. The most important thing in any examination couch is the interaction which the doctor will be having with the patient. So rather the doctor actually looping down, so what we have actually understood is that there has to be a correct posture for the doctor, and the patient may not be able to stand up or may not be able to move as per the requirement of the doctor. So the chair has to be flexible. So there has to be a direct eye contact of the patient, and we can move the chair up and down. If even required, we can rotate the chair. So this is how we actually bring out the innovative products, so as the rich interaction between the doctor and the patient happens. Similarly, when it comes to making the hospital beds, definitely a bed is a bed, but it is not like that. It has to have all the safety features. There has to be certain tests and research that have actually gone into making the hospital bed. And we have the dedicated designers where, in fact, the inspiration comes a lot from, we take from our nature. And this is one of the bed that we have actually created, what we call as chrysalis. It means transformation. So we want that the patient should heal. The whole objective of any product to be put in the hospital that it should cater to the faster healing of the patient. So our designs are based so that it gives maximum comfort and faster healing to the patients. Now we were talking of the projects. There are a lot of windows of how actually projects happen. Whenever we are actually making a hospital, so we have to actually get a lot of contractors, a lot of vendors in place, and all the planning happens in advance. For example, yes, we have to have a design cell, civil, interiors, electricals, HVAC, plumbing, and many other planning that actually happens at one site. So from the house of Godrej, what we actually do is that under one roof, we undertake all the activity and provide you the solution as per your requirement. Definitely when it comes to design, we take the external help because design is the core of how the execution will happen. We specialize in execution. How we actually measure a project at any given of point of time? Sometimes what actually happens is that the stakeholder, the owners, may not be always available at the site when the building construction is actually happening. You want to know what is the status of the work that is actually going. We call it a fever chart. This is a simple software that is on the dashboard, and it gives the progress of the work that is actually happening on the site. The small dots denotes the various activities. For example, plumbing, floor laying, HVAC work, and all parallel activities that are going. What is the status is actually denoted by the three graph. That is a red color, yellow color, and green color. So if any of the activity is out of the time, it may be indicated it is going towards red. So here we have to take action. So the stakeholder at any given point of time can see the progress just by a single glance. See, I will not go into details because ultimately managing projects is an art. We have learned a very hard way. We have been in this industry for the past 15 years while in execution, and there was a lot of learning that we went through. And definitely the key ingredients of any of the project to be successful and to meet the stakeholders' requirement and to provide the best caregiver experience as well as patient-centric healing has to be having the good planning, right knowledge of material, skilled workers at site, supervision, control and review, communication. Then, of course, control on quality. What all the material that is actually going? Is it of the quality, the right product that is actually going over there? Compliance, we talked in detail. There is a labor law compliance also that have to be met at site. And safety. Nobody can overlook safety of the workers, safety at the site, and all these things have to be controlled. One of the examples that we took, we have actually executed one of the project. This is Sakra World Hospital in Bangalore. It was a 4.5 lakh facility, around 285 beds. This is how we actually integrated everything from the House of Godrej. What you see is a reception area where we created right from the false ceiling to flooring to all the products also. Now coming to their fitness area. This is a run-through slide, so I will just run through on that part. Similarly, there are ICUs, patient rooms, VIP rooms, and different application areas. So as per the requirement of all the application area, we were able to do the interiors. And whole objective of all these activities was that we have to see that patient has to be at the center. We have to see that we create a right environment so as the healing has to be faster. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for such a lovely presentation. Well, I would request Mr. Lalit Verma, Vice President, Apollo Hospitals, to felicitate Mr. Rajiv.